Every day, thousands of people are being forced to flee their homes across the Sahel. It's one of the world's fastest growing displacement crises, fast approaching 2 million people displaced within their own countries. So why exactly are people fleeing their homes? The Sahel lies on the southern edge of the Sahara Desert and cuts across several African countries: Burkina Faso, Niger, Mali, Mauritania, and Chad. Armed groups have exploited political and ethnic tensions. Communities surviving on so little became more vulnerable. The devastating effects of climate change have made the situation worse, with flooding and drought also forcing people to flee. About 850,000 refugees have fled across borders, moving from one conflict to another. Nearly 2 million people are internally displaced, which means they've fled their homes but haven't crossed the border. Internally displaced people live in the open or in settlements. Some have been welcomed by generous hosts, like this Burkinabe chief, who welcomed 2,500 people into his home. Communities with very little are sharing everything they have. At the start of the year, the crisis was already at breaking point. COVID-19, growing insecurity, and extreme weather continue to make the humanitarian response almost impossible to manage. With no end to the Sahel crisis in sight, the UN Refugee Agency and its partners are working in extremely tough conditions to offer emergency assistance for those that continue to flee. But is there any progress? In Niger, new housing projects mean internally displaced people and refugees can move to safer areas away from insecure borders and access schools and livelihood opportunities. In Burkina Faso, refugees like Atayub, who lives as a pastoralist, received veterinary care for his animals, allowing his family to continue their way of life. In Mali, where people feel it's safe to return, they get help to start businesses or find work to rebuild their lives. There is hope, but without peace, people forced to flee their homes and the communities that host them cannot plan for the future. Every day they live with fear that the violence will continue to spread. The Sahel needs peace and help to rebuild millions of lives. They need lasting solutions. Talk about the Sahel with your friends, family, and social networks. They need their voice heard, and for the Sahel not to be forgotten.